Good day, everybody, and welcome to this webinar. Today, we will talk about batch processing. If we look at automated processing, let's say, we have batch processing. Batch processing is a solution inside PDF Toolbox desktop. This is a more manual way to process multiple files at the same time. It will help you get through repetitive work if you have several PDFs that you want to, for example, make compliance to a PDFX standard at the same time, and you don't have the server solution, you can use batch processing to process up to 100 files in a certain folder at once, well, in sequence, I suppose, automatically, inside PDF Toolbox desktop. Then the alternative, well, the professional solution is hot folder processing. This is also a way to process a lot of files automatically. The thing is, hot folder processing is more intelligent. It uses hot folders, obviously, and it will process any file that enters the int folder, no matter how many files. It will just process them in sequence. The amount of files processed at once can be set. It should not be set then higher than your core count of your processor. It's even better to keep it a bit below that, so you have some cores left over for other stuff like running your OS, for example. Hot folder processing has several advantages that batch processing does not have, which is why, of course, batch processing is in the desktop function. Well, hot folder processing is basically just how the server works. Let's have a look at both of these ways of working and see if I can explain the difference better. Batch processing works from within the switchboard. So what I did is I added the profile, upsample images that I was just using, to my workspace. You can see this little blue flag that is activated here, and not with the other fixups, the other profiles up and above. This one is blue. This means this is added into the workspace. If I say this also in the workspace, then we will have both of these in here. If you have your profile inside the switchboard, you will see when it is activated, the batch button over here in the switchboard. Now I can use this batch button. I can click it, and then I will get this pop-up window called callas PDF Toolbox Batch Processing. It has the name of the profile I'm processing, and then it has this select folder field. I can click the browse button, then select a folder. For example, if I go to documents, I have a test files folder. This is all my test files. I can open this up, and I could say start processing. Now you can see all my files are being processed. You can see it's processing them one by one. And if I have a look at my folder, this is the same folder. We might see some of these. There we go. Inside the folder I was working in, we have this upsample folder that was created with the name upsample images to 250, blah, 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 and then the date underneath of the processing. Inside that folder, automatically they are created a failure and a success folder. You can see in failure, there is one file. This is a really, really complicated test file that is filled with things that are bound to go wrong. And in success, we have all the other files that have been processed and that now contain no low resolution images. A good test we can use here is we can select our test file from earlier. We can have a look at the object inspector again. Go over this, and we see this has in fact been processed and is now 250 by 250 ppi. So that is how batch processing works. You can use any profile. Of course, any action that is already present, let's say read a still, for example, the batch is activated and you can use that as well. So it doesn't have to be a profile, but you can do it with any profile as long as you put them into the switchboard, into your workspace. So that is something a lot of people didn't actually know. It's something we also see in support every once in a while. People asking if they have to get the server for a simple process that they want to do, but they want to do it multiple times, and it is annoying to have to execute open the files, execute the profile on all their files, and then process them. So the batch processing is a big help for that, as long as you want to process all your files in the exact same manner from within PDF Toolbox Desktop. Now, this is also a good opportunity for us to take a look at the server. So let's open up the server. This is callas PDF Toolbox server, also version 10, of course. It is a separate application that you have to purchase with a more expensive license than the PDF Toolbox Desktop. I will start a server. Yes, there we are. Once the server is launched, it will look on your local server to see if you have any jobs created that should be launched. It found this one job that I used for a support case at some point, and this hot folder is in here. So I can start the hot folder here. Let's create a new one over here. Let's create a new job. We can call this job hot folder processing. You can give the job a description. Webinar 17th July 2018. We can choose a profile. So this uses all this, the same profiles that you would be able to use in the desktop or process plans or etc. So if I have the same folder here, upsample images to 250, you're going to execute this profile. For the PDF Toolbox server, because it is hot folder processing, you need to define the folders. An easy way to do this is by using the turbo button. Now, if I go to the correct location, let's go to our folder here. I can say I want that folder. And now inside the folder I pointed to, which is the folder I use for this webinar, as soon as I activate this job, there will be created a folder for end success, info, warning, error, and processed files. All these folders will be created automatically because I use the turbo button. You can set them all separately by going through these tabs and selecting the folder. Then, as you see, if I want a report on error, I can select what kind of report I want. Same for any other processed file folder. And then I can even have some activated buttons for processing subfolders. If you drop an entire folder into the in folder, that it also has to be processed, and you can set it to overwrite existing files. If a file would come into a place with the same name, it would be overwritten if you have this. This will help with, for example, the pop-up window that you would see if you are trying to save a file with the same name in the same folder, where your OS will ask you, do you want to keep both, overwrite, or cancel? Having this active will overrule that window and prevent that from blocking your automatic processing. And then we have additional CLI parameters. This is also interesting in the PDF Toolbox server. PDF Toolbox server actually runs exactly like the PDF Toolbox command line interface. So you can actually see this as a sort of visual interface, a visual user interface for the command line processing. So, which means if you have CLI parameters that you can't put into a profile and you can't input here in the settings, then you can add these below. That could, for example, be no optimization. That wasn't correct. Optimization. You can add that into the CLI parameters, and then it will also be taken into consideration while processing. So I can say OK. We should see this appear. There we go, hot folder processing. I can start this hot folder. This will create those. There we go. If I go back to my folder, you can see we now have an error in info process success and warning folder in here. If I drop this 155, let's copy it into the in folder. And we go back, we shall see here that it is running. It found the file and it processed the file. And now if we go back to that finder window, then we should see in the success folder, this is the successful file, and in the processed folder, the original file that has been processed without changes. So if I go to Toolbox, I close this file, I open this file and the success file. I hope that first one was on it from the original folder. We can hover. Yes, we can see if I hover over this, it says 150 by 150. This is the original file that has been processed. If I go to the processed file, we shall see it is 250 by 250. So it has been processed. And you can see it just appears in the success and in the processed folder. So that is the difference between the server and the batch processing in PDF Toolbox Desktop. The hot folder processing allows for a lot more automation because you can just set, for example, any workflow solution, think for example a switch, to drop files into the in folder that can then be retrieved from a processed files folder. You can also set that in folder somewhere on a server, have your people drop files into the in folder that then get processed on the server and then retrieve them from an out folder that's on a different location. And that way you can process files automatically. So what you would do is you would set up a job for all the different kinds of processing that you do. For example, if you have different output solutions and you have a different way of processing files to prepare them for each of those output solutions, let's say an offset press where everything has to be CMYK and a digital press where you have to go to multicolor, for example, you can have multiple queues for that. Process your files through these queues and have them come out on the other side automatically without having to go into PDF Toolbox Desktop, open a file, select the correct profile, execute, save the file manually, and then retrieve it. So server is a good way to go if you have a lot of files to process. In desktop, you can process multiple files in batch processing, but it is still a manual thing to do. So that is the main difference, automation versus manual processing.